everybody. I hope you're doing well, you know, taking care, and welcome to my channel. Today, we're gonna be making Miraculous Ladybug and Cat Noir inspired chokers. Today, I'm gonna teach you how to make these two beautiful chokers right here. And just a heads up, I will not be talking about the series, because if you're watching it, I don't want to give anybody no spoilers, but if you're not watching it, you definitely should. Look how beautiful these are. So now, let's head on to the tutorial. These are the materials that you're going to need to make your ladybug inspired choker. So these are some of the beads that I chose. I chose red because that's the color, and the charm is a ladybug charm, so it's gonna look super cute. And now we're just gonna start off by taking our string, and I just used a choker that I already made for myself as a reference for the length. I don't like it too tight, but I don't like it too loose either. So I just went on and proceeded to pinch one of the sides of the cord so I could start adding on those beads. I'm gonna show the pattern right now, and I'm gonna explain the pattern here on the screen. You're gonna see the pattern explained. Look how beautiful it looks. I really like how shiny it is too. I really like the color red. It looks absolutely cute and beautiful. And now we're just gonna finish this off. Now you're going to take your crimping bead and put it on one of the sides of the extra string of the choker, because then you're gonna take a little jump ring. After you put it like that, you're gonna take a jump ring and put it on top. After you put the jump ring on top, which I'm going to demonstrate now with one of the jump rings that I have right here, you're gonna kinda loop it together, and then you're gonna take the crimping bead and press it. You're gonna kinda like squish it, you know, with one of your pliers, because that's what is gonna hold it together. It's gonna hold it sturdy and still. As you can see right now is the part where I'm gonna demonstrate how to do the little loop with the crimping bead. Look at right here. You can see it up close and nicely. This is how you do it, and just pull it. As you can see, it's gonna all get pulled together, and voila, you're almost done. Now, like I said before, you're gonna take your pliers and you're gonna press that little bead. You're gonna squish it like this right now. I'm gonna show it right here. You're just gonna squish it. If your jump ring is a little open, you can always just fix it. And just like this, one of the sides of the beautiful choker is already done. And for the other one, you're just gonna take another jump ring and put on your lobster clasp on it. I had kind of a hard time doing this, but you know, this is how you open and close jump rings. I'm gonna show it right here. And then you're gonna proceed to put on your lobster clasp and then close it back together. And as you did with the first side, you're gonna take another crimping bead, put it on first, like thread it on first, and then you put the jump ring with the lobster clasp and make that little loop. And just like that, you will be quickly done with your choker. I think I made this choker in around 10 to 15 minutes, because sometimes putting in the little bead and grabbing it again to, you know, make the little loop and squish it can be hard because it's so small. And you see, I struggle a little bit, but then I could do it. After you are done with both sides, and ignore my nails, I'm the type of person that has messy nails when you try to paint your nails at night, so excuse me for that. And now, after you did both of your sides, you're just gonna add the little charm. Remember, this is just inspiration. You can make the same one as I did, or you can make your own pattern, you know, just be creative as you want. As you can see, I just took my flush cutters and I cut the excess thread, and voila, this is the necklace. And now I'm gonna show you how to make the little charm. If you have a bead that is too big, like that one, it kind of falls off, you can take a smaller one, put it underneath, and put the other part on top, just like I did right here. And you're gonna do the pinch and bend like I showed in my previous video. If you haven't seen that video, you should definitely watch it. And then you're just gonna take your flush cutters, you're gonna cut the excess part. After you cut that excess part, you're gonna take your round nose pliers and you're gonna make a loop, because from that loop, we're gonna proceed to take a big jump ring and put it on, and then put it on the choker. Also, if you have any suggestions or questions, remember to leave them down below in the comments. Anyhow, has everybody seen all the episodes of Miraculous? If you have, please comment down below. What's your favorite scene? What's your favorite character? What's your favorite Miraculous too? And now proceeding with our Ladybug choker. You're gonna take your big jump ring, open it, add your charm, and then close it, but on the necklace first. Like, don't close it before, just close it after you put it on. I personally put it in the middle, it just looks better that way, it looks so much nicer. And now you will soon see the results of this beautiful choker. Honestly, I'm obsessed with it. If you like it and you want to purchase it, you just let me know in the comment section. I have no problem in sending it over. So just let me know.
Make the chokers. I don't make them personally. I don't like them like this that much. I feel like this length is a little bit more beautiful, a little bit more fancy, a little bit more simple, and that's just how the way I make it. I really like it like this, and I think it looks absolutely cute. So if you have a bestie, a friend, or somebody you want to give a gift to and they're a fan of the show, this is actually a pretty good idea.
And now for the Cat Noir choker, follow the same steps as the Ladybug choker. The only thing that's changing here is the pattern that I use. And at the end, that little cat charm, I ended up not using it. Remember, you can be as creative as you want. You can do the pattern as you like. Now I'm just gonna be quickly showing how I made it. And the pattern is pretty much pretty similar to the other one. Just the beads are different colors and different types of beads. For this particular piece, I wanted to add a hint of green because we know Cat Noir's Miraculous has green. So yeah, I added 3 green jades. Quick reminder, my shop link is in my bio. In case you're looking for some cute jewelry or you're interested in purchasing one of these chokers, just let me know in the comments, guys. And now, time to speed all of this up so we can finish up quickly.
So that's all we have for today. If you have any questions, remember to comment down below and let me know if you would make these, what would you change, what are your thoughts of these. Remember to subscribe, like, and maybe share this video with a friend, and see you next week. Thank you. Bye.